Good afternoon to all once again. Yeah, if you have any queries, please put forward. Either you can type it in the chat box or you can directly have a discussion with me, no problem. So if you have any queries, please put forward for the previous week's discussions. Anyway, the assignment deadlines have been extended so that you can do it. It is not in a hurry, but please do complete in time as far as you can. For some of you, some difficulties are there. Hope everything will be resolved very soon. For a few of them, I have expressed their concern about submission of the assignments. But anyway, we can we keep on extending it. And if you have any other subject doubts or any activity doubts, please let me know. Please remember, this particular course is a practical course, a lab course, as far as our curriculum is concerned. So this is basically a lab component. That's why we have 3-hour sessions in a week. So let me tell you, I think around 46 students are there now. So please do remember, this session is for 3 hours. So most likely I will be taking the entire session. I will be on live. If you have any queries during these 3 hours, you can discuss with me, you can chat with me, and you can clarify your doubts. And of course, as I have seen in a couple of weeks in the previous cases, where some of you have, after the class is over or after the discussion of that particular topic, after 1.5 hours, some of them are signing out. So I cannot make you to forcibly listen for all the 3 hours, but nevertheless, please be online. So the topics of discussion, during the discussion, some important points will be dwelled upon and there will be some discussions goes on. So you may be missing those points. So for simple reasons, do not sign out the session. You please be online and we can also discuss. So the more discussions will happen, then definitely it will be more fruitfulness for us. So for you also, you can also be very confident, and you can also have some kind of easiness in doing the task. Of course, the topics, what I'm giving you is the introductory topics with the basic information, and I'm asking you to do the exercises. And in that process, definitely you may be exploring or you may be browsing other videos or other material on the net. Of course, I will not say you don't do those things, but see, when you please stick to the exercises what I am trying to give to you. So you please look into that particular set of exercises and try to understand how best you can try to solve those exercises for the given questions. That is most important. Of course, if you look into the depth of the course, the depth of the course is very vast for the web technologies or for this internet technologies. If you go, it will be very vast with the latest technologies too. So you should not wander with all those things. Don't think that all that information is also required for you. And in that process, what happens is you will get confused yourself when you look into more resources from the net. So that confusion will always arise when you look into the more resources from the internet or from the YouTube or from the Google or from the GitHub. If you look, so there will be so many topics, so much of exploration is already done. So some are, I cannot say that all those things are not required, some of you may already have some basic skills and the basic knowledge on these web technologies and the internet technologies, but please focus and try to have the scope of our work is looking to the exercises and the syllabus what we have prescribed. So you should not go beyond that prescribed syllabus. That is the most important thing. And I will advise you that please do not sign out the session once our 1 to 1.5 hour session of the topic presentation is over. So after the presentation of the topic, you still can have discussions. And of course, from today onwards, I will be again interacting with you all, each one of you. Individually, I will also see how you are doing on your systems. So like earlier cases, now once again it will be started up the process. So because I need to monitor and I need to look into how far you are able to do. If you are having any difficulties, please let me know, so that I will also try to resolve it as quickly as possible. Yeah, any other queries, please, from the previous week's discussions or from the previous topics? Am I audible to you? Hello, can anyone of you please respond? Yeah, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, so let us move forward. If you are not having any queries at this moment, that's fine. But anyway, please clarify if you have any kind of silly doubts also, do not hesitate to ask me. And please let me know what is your difficulties, if at all you are facing. Otherwise, I will be in an assumption that we are moving forward with our topics to be covered. And I think the syllabus is getting covered. More outputs, of course, the assignment corrections. Please, I'd like to inform you that TAs are also there, and Mr. Srinivas Raju is also attending this session today. Yes, he is there online.
And, good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon. So, regarding your evaluations, so you can contact Srinivas Raju by email, or you can discuss after my presentation is over now. You can discuss with him. You do not feel shy, do not get hesitated to ask him. If you are not clear with the marks awarded also, you can try to clarify with you. So we are always positive. Please, yeah, his email ID is given in the chat box. You can directly contact him through email at any time regarding the evaluations or any clarifications also on the doubts. Or you can also ask me. There is no problem. So we are all positive for you. So we all want you to gain the knowledge and gain the skills. That is the most important here. We are not the persons like try to cut your marks for some silly reasons. So yeah, and please do not wait till the last minute. That's what we are in the already on the half of the semester is over now. So we are on the half mark of our syllabus completion also. Please, if at all any doubts are there, please let us know as quickly as possible. Please do not wait till the end of the semester marks. Please remember, as far as this course is concerned, I repeat once again, this is a lab course. So there will be 50 marks evaluation will be there. And see, because the final examination as such will not be there. So minor exams on the lab component will be there. So that will also constitute another 50% of the marks. So 50% of the marks on the assignment and the 50% marks on your minor 1 and 2. So please make sure that you try to clarify. So the examination dates, I will announce it by tomorrow. Please look into the course webpage or Moodle course webpage. Please keep monitoring that regarding the assessment and the when the examinations for the minor exams will be there. I will be keep posting on the course web page from tomorrow onwards. So please keep monitoring your course pages. And if any kind of evaluation doubt or any doubts, please do not hesitate to ask us. Then don't wait till the last day of our semester. Please remember that. Yeah. So it's almost now 50 students are there. So let me just move ahead for our today's topic. So if you can see on our course page, already I posted the material for you, the contents for this week. Of course, for this today's session is on jQuery and Ajax. So we will try to go into the introduction to jQuery and the introduction to Ajax. And we'll see the what exercises to be done. And of course, I'll also ask you to do those things on your systems after my presentation is over. I hope you are able to retrieve these materials from the course webpage.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. So the jQuery and Ajax material are there. So please try to download the materials from this. So of course, my presentation slides looks like very simple, but a lot of information and a lot of knowledge and skills can be gained. So I start from the beginning, means I presume that a beginner is going to read this material and start working on it. So already somebody is known to these things, of course it looks like very trivial, but you do not go into that impression that it is very simple material. So I always repeat or try to present the contents keeping in view of the beginner or those students who are not known to these technologies at all. Because definitely there are some few students will be there. Out of 54 students, there will be some students who are not known to these technologies at all. So we cannot ignore them and we cannot bypass them and start it and directly go for some complex application implementation. So we'll start with very small things and we'll slowly go into the little bit more in depth on the exercises. And of course, in the mid examinations, to some extent on the applications and so on and so forth. So let us start with a jQuery. jQuery, in that jQuery, J stands for your something which is related to your JavaScript. So the main purpose of this jQuery is write less and do more. Basically, what is that you are going to write less and what is that it is the functionality which is going to give you more is something like this. So jQuery is a fast and concise JavaScript library. Basically, you know what is a library is. So we use this library to make our web developing activities very easy and in a simplified manner. So this library, jQuery library, will help us to manage and manipulate our HTML elements, that is your web elements, the elements which are there on your web pages. So you can move upon those web elements easily. That means you can traverse the elements from one section or from one context to another context, or from one division to another division, and from one place to another place on your web page itself. And it can also handle the events very easily. So event-driven programming, so how you to handle the events when the events occur on your web pages, like user clicks some buttons on the web page, or user is trying to move the mouse pointer or mouse hover. So whatever the activities the user is trying to do on the web pages, how they have to be handled very easily and in a very simplified manner with respect to the JavaScript programming, that can be easily done with our jQuery functionalities. So in this jQuery is more or less nowadays, because a lot of multimedia data is being presented on the web pages, which includes your animations and some kind of asynchronous data exchanges between the client and the server, between your web page and the data that is coming from a server. So all these activities, all these interactions, how the data is going to be retrieved from the server, or that is from the web server or from another web resource which is located across the internet, and how best you can develop these applications in a very easy and a fast manner. So all these kinds of the latest technology that is going to be helpful for us in developing a dynamic and a very simplified, in a simplified manner, you can prepare your web contents in a more easy and a flexible way. So in order to make that web contents development in a more easy and a concise and a more simplified manner, this jQuery is going to be very much useful for us. So whenever you write a JavaScript, so why do you write a JavaScript, or what is the purpose of a JavaScript? Can anybody tell me? Let me just come back to this to have a small discussion over here. Can anyone please dwell upon what is the purpose of the JavaScript with respect to our web pages? Just to have some interaction.
For the validation.
Yes, so we can make use of the JavaScript for doing some web page validations, cross-checking before the data is being sent to the web server. Some kind of checks can be performed on the web pages. Yes, okay. Using JavaScript, we can do validation. That is the only thing. Only through for validation we use JavaScript at the client side. Yes, please.
Dynamic web page.
We can make it more interactive.
Yeah, more interactive, more dynamic. Yes, very good. Dynamic, dynamism, interactivity can be improved. User interactions. Yes, okay. Dynamism, interactions, validations. Only these three important things for JavaScript. I have listed you many things. If you look to the JavaScript my notes, my slide gives you a lot of information too. Apart from these three, any other views, please, from some of you, please speak out. No problem. Just let us have some interaction.
Sir, behavior of the application JavaScript.
Yeah, dynamic behavior interactions. If you look to my slide, I mentioned about you can incorporate artificial intelligence methods, machine learning methods too, using the help of JavaScript on your web pages, on your web sites, on your web resources. So you can incorporate your artificial intelligence methods, AI methods, ML methods, deep learning methods nowadays still. You can do your animations, multimedia data interactions. So you can design your web pages and you can do a lot of things with your JavaScript. But what happened is the JavaScript, when you start writing the program will be very much lengthier and very much complex when you are going for more information that needs to be displayed or to be presented onto your web pages. So to overcome all this and to have a very handy and very simplified manner, that's what the jQuery. jQuery is a library. Please remember, it is a library which will help us to write less number of statements, write less number of executable statements or your instructions. And with that less number of statements, you can do more work. You means your web page is going to do more functionalities. Something like this. jQuery program or your jQuery script that involves in your web page may involve like this, something like this. Please see here. It starts with your, of course, in the script tag. You are going to include a library. So of course, this library is jQuery.minifiedversion.js. So if you see at the source of this library, if you have an internet connection, then you can provide the CDN, the developer networks, the content developer network link can be provided so that you can access the library. Along this 3.4.1 is basically the version, jQuery library version, and that is the library file name is jQuery.min.js. If you don't have internet connection and if you want to run this jQuery library on your web pages, then you can download this jQuery.min.js and you can store this jQuery.min.js locally onto your system, and you can use that particular library for your various functionalities for your various web pages. So here, I hope, is my slide, are my slides are visible to you?
Yes, sir.
So once you included this library in your web page under the script tag, then you are using something on the after the script tag is over, then we have seen that there is something called dollar symbol. So this dollar symbol always implies that the particular statement is referring to a jQuery statement. So all these are jQuery statements here, please, which are given with the dollar symbol. Dollar document dot ready function, dollar height dot click function, dollar p dot height, followed by dollar show dot click function, dollar p dot show. So these are all some jQuery functions, basically jQuery instructions. So this particular logic of this statements is that there's a lot of meaning is involved here. So we'll see what is this. This is just a snippet. There's a small sample which I've shown you here, how the program looks like. But let us go into this particular programming statements and understand what these program statements and how they are going to be used and how you have to use it in your programs for your jQuery utilization. So usually whenever a web page is loaded onto your browser, a web page is rendered onto your browser, so we see that particular web page or that window, we can call it as a window or you can call it as a web page, is loaded on load. So window.onload is basically implies that that particular web page is loaded on our browser, which is rendered on our browser, or that some data is coming from some web server onto our web browser. Once it is, the data is made available on the web browser, that web page is been loaded, and in internally there is nothing but we term it as window.onload. So this window.onload is basically is our document object model, a DOM way. This is a, in the DOM way we do write like this: window.onload is equal to some function. Function is the keyword here, open brace followed by closing brace. Then the corresponding do stuff with the DOM, whatever you want to do with that corresponding. When the window is loaded onto the browser, and the window is, the web page is being seen on the browser, so some stuff, some activity, some event handling, some kind of user interactive can be happening once the web page is made available on the browser. And once the user sees that web page, some events can be happening. So that corresponding logic, we need to write it for that particular function logic. Similarly, you write something like this: once a window on load, window.onload function, that when you are writing in the jQuery, we are writing something like this: dollar followed by document. The document implies that web page. So that document dot ready. So dot ready function, it always tells that the web page is loaded on the browser. It means the user is able to see something on the browser. That particular document, that web page document, is now ready, and it is made available to be seen on the browser. So this is what the equivalent jQuery translation for that particular window.onload is equal to, whatever the functionality that you are going to write it when the window is loaded onto your browser. So document.ready function is the equivalent jQuery statement when the web page is loaded onto your browser. Please remember that. And this is the syntax. The syntax is, once again I repeat the syntax, dollar is the keyword. You have to mention that particular symbol with the open brace, then followed by document. So the document is referring to your web page only. Once it is loaded onto your browser, it is to be implied that it is in the ready state. So dot ready, once it has been loaded onto your browser, you try to provide the corresponding logic what needs to be done here. So this is what the syntax for writing it. So here open flower brace and closing flower brace, the entire logic is to be written. So ready function, this function ready itself has got an internal function parameter, the logic of that particular function when the web page is loaded. So the corresponding close of that ready function is given here at the end of that particular closing brace followed by a semicolon. So entire statement is basically a jQuery statement. So it is a lot of JavaScript statements are being minimized here, and we write only the dot document function. So dollar followed by document.ready, and the corresponding logic is written in this function itself, which is an internal function to the ready function itself. And the jQuery of writing this function definition, if you are going to write a function itself, we write it with the dollar function. So let us see here what is the use of this jQuery. So if you see our DOM tree, the document object model tree, so on the top hierarchy we have an HTML as a root element. So under the HTML root element you have the shells. Of course the shells are basically two parent shells for the other children here in this hierarchy. One shell, parent shell, is the head section, and followed by the body section, two important parent sections. And again in the head section you can have something like the tags, your title, the metadata, and of course you can put your scripts or the libraries can be included here in this head section. And if you come to the body section, of course your normal body elements, the other elements such as headings, paragraphs, list elements, or your unordered list elements, all the HTML elements which have been user interactivity, and those components or those elements have been interacted with the user, can be corresponding elements which have been described and which have been presented in the body section. So if you look to this DOM tree, so here the entire DOM tree is going to be helpful for you to access the elements. So this is the hierarchical way. May I know why this hierarchical way of representation of your elements in the DOM tree structure is going to be useful for us in in our web development or in our web applications. Yes, please.
Sir, as you also told earlier, it is easy to like go deep and deep. That's why we use this. Easily, yeah. We can apply binary search kind of algorithms on it to save some time and efficiently make our access to different web pages linked to each other.
Yes, yes, Amit, you are rightly said. Already I said, instead of flat file structure, you always go for a hierarchical structure where it not only for searching, it need not be binary search, it is a searching process in general. You are searching, you are traversing, or you are to manage the elements or manipulate the elements, it's going to be very, very useful for us. So that's what you can identify the elements properly on your web page, because in your web page you'll have hundreds and thousands of elements will be there. So most likely you'll be giving IDs, the identification with their element IDs or with your tag names or your class names, whatever it may be. So the identifications can be easily helpful for you to retrieve those elements. You can do the traverses and you can do the manipulation with those objects. You can change the behavior of those elements. And these are all the things which can be happening with respect to only a DOM tree structure that is mostly useful for our web applications or our web development. So if you look to how jQuery is going to be made use for accessing those elements or getting those elements by IDs or by tag names. So if you see in the table earlier, when we have written the JavaScript program for accessing or for retrieving or for manipulation of those elements for various DOM objects. So we may have used the tags here, get the attributes, you have used it along with the tag names. So get element by ID, get elements by tag name, get elements by name, query selectors for the CSS operations. So like this, you have a query selector all. If you see, these are the descriptions which we are used in various web page elements. The same thing, now these DOM objects can be accessed, can be made use with the help of jQuery itself. So when you are using a jQuery statement, you can use with the dollar symbol. Always remember, all your elements of your web pages can be accessed or can be made use with the help of your dollar symbol. When you are using the dollar symbol, it implies that you are using the jQuery functionality. Please remember that. So here, something like this, you are writing dollar my ID, which we need to understand here. So that dollar followed by anything which you are going to, dollar followed by anything which you are giving the element. So it means you are accessing that element and you are going to store that value with that in the variable in the JavaScript, like your ID selectors. If you are using the group selectors for the paragraphs, again, it is going to be used with the dollar symbol. If you are going to have a context selector with the division, the which we are going to refer it, you can use your dollar symbol. If you are using any other class specification for your CSS and all, also you have to use it with your dollar. So please remember all the jQuery equivalents. Please remember the dollar ID, dollar tag, dollar name by class name or by some elements by name, or dollar selector. It always implies that dollar symbol, and if you are using the elements on your web scripts, it implies that you are referring to jQuery itself. So let us see some demos here, please. And of course, I'll give the codes for you in the course pages once our demonstration is over. So let me open the codes and let me explain to you, and we'll try to understand how we can use these things. So yeah, jQuery example one. So I'm just opening a notepad editor here, right? So here, this is a very simple your HTML file. So in this, you are using your script tag. The first script is basically referring to using the library. So you are always remember, whenever you are using dollar symbols in your program, please remember you need to include your library. So the inclusion of the library, you can do it in the head section, or you can do it at the external, or it is up to you. Like, how do you include your libraries for your JavaScript? The same principles do work for your jQuery too. So 3.5.1 is the latest jQuery version number, and the corresponding file name is jQuery.minified.js version. So now here, this is once you included your jQuery library. Now let us see here how the program is written here. So here, let me just show line by line to you. Let me just cut this one. Oh, sorry, just one second. Before you go through the program, right? So this is your ordinary program here. What do you see here carefully? In the body section, you have three paragraphs. First paragraph is, if you click on me, I will disappear. Then the second paragraph is, click me away. And the third paragraph is also, click me too. But there are three different paragraphs, three different web page elements. So here, let me just save this file and try to understand, once I run this particular program, how the program looks like. So here, a simple HTML file just displaying three different paragraphs. So the first paragraph is, if you click me, I will disappear. Okay, if the text is not clear, let me maximize. Okay, now I think you can see the text. Right. So if you click on me, I will disappear. Click me away, this is second paragraph. And click me too, this is, yes, there are three elements. This is the first paragraph element, this is the second paragraph element, and this is your third paragraph element, or third paragraph, you can say. These are all three different elements. Of course, there's nothing functionality is written here in this. So I'm just clicking the text, nothing is happening here. Now I'll try to add some functionality to this. So what functionality? If I click this first paragraph, it has to disappear. Similarly, if I click the second, it has to disappear. If I click the third, it has to disappear. It means if I click any of this paragraph, it has to disappear. So disappear, that is just to hide those paragraphs, which is not there in this particular. So how do you put that functionality? Using the jQuery, very simple thing. So what we write here is, right. So let me just come line by line for you here. So here, so the first line, what we are writing is a script, $document.ready. So what does this implies? Just now I told you in the beginning of the session, $document, your web page document. That web page document, once this web page document is loaded onto this particular screen, screen in the sense you loaded onto this browser. So this is the web page. The document is now loaded or rendered onto the web browser. It means shown on the browser. That is only just, it is a window.onload only. Basically, it is another web, is a one of the web page which has been loaded. So yeah, so once this particular web page is loaded, the document is ready. That's what your jQuery statement is. So document, the syntax is dollar followed by open brace within the document. That is, document itself is one object. Dot, that object dot ready. Ready means it is loaded on the browser. What is that? You are writing a function. This is a function, this is a keyword here, function, the functionality. So as of the function open floor brace, yes, the function, you are writing the function here. The function, inside this function, at this moment, nothing is here. So open floor brace and the closing floor brace, the red color, you can see it here. Followed by closing, this is your closing, this closing is for this ready function, followed by the semicolon. So this, the logic inside this jQuery statement. So what is that? You are writing the event handling logic. So what is that event handling logic here is, you are writing $P. So what is this P implies? This P is referring to the, which particular element? Can anybody tell me which element it is referring to? Yes, please. This P is an element. This element P is referring to?
Paragraph.
Any one of this paragraph, all P is, this is a tag. So it can be either the first statement, it can be the second paragraph, or it can be the third paragraph. Basically, all these three paragraphs have been referred with this paragraph P, the tag name here. The tag itself is P here. If you want to specifically refer to a particular paragraph, you have to give, what you have to do then? Can anybody tell me?
ID.
Yes, you need to assign some ID to that. So something like this, ID is equal to P1, you are going to assign that. So you know what is an ID attribute is. So then if you are giving ID here, and if you are going to write the jQuery statement, then what needs to be written here? Can anybody tell me? If I want to only refer to only this P1, the first paragraph, with this, which is given
P1,
with
the ID. Sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, P1, sir.
It is
hash P1.
Yes, it is equivalent. The jQuery equivalent statement I have written here. Please remember here. Dollar. Can you see the slide here, please? Can you
yes,
see the
sir,
slide?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, see, it is given in the slide itself. A dollar within quotes hash ID, the corresponding ID, whatever the ID which you are referring. So hash P1 it will be coming here, of course. So anyway, you need to practice it. I will just give these basics first at this moment. Let us not go. Let us not confuse much here. So dollar P. Okay. So dollar P, P is referring to this particular element of this. That is a paragraph element. What is the functionality here? Dot. Click.
Click.
So where is the definition for this click function? Can anybody say, tell me? Did we write any definition or did we write any logic? What is the meaning of this click function is?
No.
Sorry, it's predefined in the.
Yes, please. Can any only one at a time, please?
Sir, in the script source that we have given, it is.
Yeah, it is there. Yeah, it is there in this library. Please remember. That's what you write less and do more. In the first sentence, in this library, jQuery.min.js. The definition of this particular click function will be there. Please, you have to open it and you have to see that. Please remember. Let us see that function in the later. So, but so at moment, at this moment, I am telling you, this click is this a predefined function. That is a predefined function you are using. So the paragraph P is been clicked. Then what if it is click? Yes, the click function is been invoked. Again, the syntax is click is a function. Then again, for this there is open floor brace and there is a corresponding closing floor brace. What needs to be done for this when the paragraph is being clicked? Dollar this. So this is referring to which particular object or which particular element? Can anyone say?
Correct context.
Please, yes, please.
Para element we have clicked.
The paragraph element which we have clicked. Yes, the current paragraph, the paragraph which the user has clicked. It is this particular object variable. This is a pointer variable. This is referring to the current object. The current object is the paragraph which the user is going to click. And what needs to be done with that particular paragraph? That particular paragraph tag. It needs to be
hidden.
Hidden. That is some functionality you are trying to understand. So this click and hide function, they have been already predefined. They have been already available in this library. So we are just using that library and we are making use that library very much using very much in the easiest manner to use some kind of functionality to the existing elements. So you just need to understand the syntaxes, please. That is the most important here. So for a beginner, it will be a little bit clumsy with everything something in terms of dollar. But if you slowly practice it, it will be very easy and it is very helpful for you. And big programs can be easily minimized with this jQuery statements. That's what write less, do more. You are going to write only. So if you are going to write a JavaScript program without this jQuery, yes, you can write it. But that program with the number of lines of that will be more, very more, and depends on the functionality which you are going to incorporate here. So with this only just three lines of code, you are able to write less and do more functionality here. So let us see how this function when it's written and executed. So now just your jQuery statement as written, when the document is ready, when the document is loaded on the browser, and when the user clicks the paragraph, and that paragraph has to be hidden. That's what this logic is, very simple logic. So let us now go to this file and see how this execution looks like. So here, yes, so now I hope you are able to see my mouse pointer, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I just clicked on those three lines. It is already hidden. So if I click only first line, please remember, just with one click, it is hidden. If I click the third one, it is hidden. If I click the second one, it is also hidden. So just this is just adding a functionality to this statements when the user clicks so and so element. The element here itself is the paragraph, and you have written the function as something like it has to be hidden. So this is one particular small program which you can easily understand about what the jQuery is and how do we write it. So let us move to the next program. This is another example, right, with little bit more number of lines. Okay, can anybody tell me now? So you have to tell me what is written here, and let us see how the discussion goes on. It is not very big complex task, a complex thing here. So let me close this and let me minimize this. All right. Yeah. Can anybody come forward to explain this very simple program? Of course, I have not told what this program is, but at least by looking to this programming instructions, you should be able to tell. Yes, please.
By clicking the button, it's changing its pixel size.
Clicking the button, it is going to change the pixel size.
No, sir.
Not exactly that, Raghavendra. Raghavendra, you need to just little bit think more. Oh, yeah, Sachin, please go ahead.
It will move right direction 600 pixels.
Yes. So that's what exactly, when you click the button, one particular, what is that is going to move? Can anybody tell me? And that is written here in the
division that.
Yes, which division? The division which is given here, the style which is given in the background. So here, what is this particular thing? That is the height and the width. So 100 by 100, one square box with this particular background image, background color, is just moving some. So you can do some animations also. That's what you see. Only few lines of code we have written here using jQuery, and we do some kind of animation too. So let me just quickly give you this explanation of this code, then you can understand more clearly here. So the first, I am including the jQuery library. So the jQuery library is included in the script file. If this is what your jQuery library is included, 3.5.1 jQuery library. Then followed by the definition of this jQuery. So if you remove this, let me show you what the actual HTML file looks like. So if you see here, there is in the body section, there is a button. The button with just a start animation text, there is a button with this start animation, and there is a paragraph. So, and there is another a division with another context or with another element. So how many elements are there in this one, in this web page? How many different elements?
Three elements.
One is your button element, another is your paragraph element, another is your just a particular division which is indicating certain information here in this attributes. So the paragraph elements, by default, all HTMLs have a static position and cannot be moved. So that is just as to manipulate the positions, remember to first set the CSS position property of the element to relative, fixed or absolute. So just an information for you. And in this division, if you run this program without the jQuery, how the program looks like, let us see here first. Open the program in the browser, jQuery example 2. Yes, so your output looks like this. So there is a button, there is a paragraph, and there is a picture. If I click this button, nothing is happening here. Please remember, because you have not written the functionality. You are not told what to be done when the button is clicked. So at this moment, there is a square box with this light green color. That's nothing is happening. This is another paragraph, which is also nothing is going to happen here. So let us write this particular code now and add some functionalities using through the jQuery. So what is the functionality we added through jQuery here? Please first see, once the first statement is $document.ready. So the once the web page is ready, once the web page is loaded on the browser, once the web page is rendered, all means the same. Rendering means or loading the web page on the browser, or document is been shown, web document is been shown on the browser, means it has been seen by the like this, it is seen on the browser. You can see this. See, I'm seeing the web document on the browser. So it is all means the same. When the document is loaded on the browser, or when the document is ready. So once the document is ready, something is, so the some events are going to happen. Only the events are going to happen only when the document is loaded. That's why the first statement will be, always you write $document.ready function. Once the web page is only loaded on the browser, then only you have to do something here. One, if it is not there, obviously you are not going to do anything. So once the document is loaded, so what is that dollar button? So button is referring to which one? Button is referring to this particular tag button itself. So that button is click. Button is clicked. Previously you have seen a paragraph is click. Please remember. So now we are seeing a button is clicked. Actually, the property of the button itself is click button. So once the click button is been pressed, once the button is clicked, function, what you need to be, what should be done here? Dollar division. Dollar div. Div is what? This is the division. So the division is nothing but it has got a style background with some color. That's what you can see. This is a light green color with the hash number 98BF2N. You can change it nothing yet. With the height and 100 pixels and the width 100 pixels. And position is basically your absolute position. It means position at a particular location once the web page is loaded. And what we are doing with this division, we are doing some animation. That animation is nothing but animation involves your animation basically involves your moving the object from one position to another position and some doing certain rotations or some image transformations. So rotations, translations, your information, all these rotations, translations, changing, modifying the picture, all this implies the animations itself. So animations, what you are doing in the animation, you are moving that right 600 pixels from the current position to absolute position to 600 pixels. It has to be moved when the button is clicked, and the button is going to be clicked only when the document is made available to the user to view it on the browser. It means the document is in ready. So that's what this logic of this particular jQuery statement here. Once you write this, and we let us see this execution now, how the output is going to look like. So this one, I'm just refreshing it, added it. So start animation. So here, okay, I have added the code and I have not saved it. Yes, I have saved this now. And let me refresh. So this particular element has moved from the absolute position to 600 pixels to the right side. So that's what just you, with some kind of animations. So here the jQuery, the important thing that you need to understand is the jQuery. So it is very writeless, only writing only few lines of code, and you are managing, you are manipulating the elements on click, on focus, on renderings, on animations, like this. Anything you can do you according to your application requirements, and you try to process those data based on your application requirements. So that will be very easy by writing with the help of your jQuery. So the jQuery library does all this helpful for us. So let us see one more example also now. Let us, any queries, any doubts, please let me know. Up to now, any doubts on this jQuery? Yes, please. Hello, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to follow?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So let us see very a little bit more more interesting thing. I will also make you to have an example and have some kind of exercise for you. So let us see fetching JSON data from a URL using jQuery example. Using jQuery, we'll try to fetch JSON data from a URL. URL means from a website. So the website is basically, you can also use this website. Is anybody aware of this particular website?
No, sir.
Yeah, this is basically a fake website. This website is basically used for, yes, let me, so you can use this JSON placeholder website. It is basically meant for practicing purpose. It is a free fake API for testing and prototyping. Because as of now, we have not studied any web server. Please remember, once you understand the JSPs and the web servers, again, we can implement all these experiments on your web server. See, at this moment, we don't have any web server with us. So we can take the help of this website, jsonplaceholder.typecode.com. So here on this website, you can see there are certain JSON data files are there. So what is the purpose of a JSON? Can anybody tell me the JSON? We have already discussed this JSON in the last week. What is the abbreviation for JSON? Yes, please.
JavaScript object.
JavaScript object notation.
Notation. Yeah. What is the purpose of this JavaScript object notation?
Transfer of data and storing. Transfer of data.
Transfer of data. Only transfer?
Data exchange between server and client.
Yeah, data exchange or a data transfer. Both meanings are going to be the same here.
Store data in particular pattern.
Yes, store and exchange. Please remember, don't say simply exchange. Store and exchange. Storing the data in a very simple and a very conducive manner. Conducive means very appropriate manner. So storing the data and exchanging the data. Storing and exchanging data between whom or between which parties or which between what? Yes, please. Exchange of data between whom? When you say exchange, yeah, between client server, between any two entities, between any two web resources, between any two web parties, between any two web applications, you can exchange your data. Once, if you are looking for exchange of data between two any entities, please remember any two devices is important, that storage and that representation is going to be very useful. So JSON is advantageous when compared to, what is that another way of representation and exchange of data?
XML.
Very good, XML. So JSON is going to be more advantageous than your XML. In what way it is more advantageous? This difference also I told in the last week's discussion, please. Can you please brief me about this?
Parsing is easy.
Parsing is easy, very good. Of course, yes, parsing is easy. That is one thing. Apart from that, what are the other advantages we have of JSON representation compared to XML?
Lightweight.
Very good. Lightweight, the right terms you are using, lightweight. In what way it is lightweight?
No need of tags like that.
Yeah, it is no need of tags like what we use the tags in the XML. This is extended markup language. You use tags. Tags will eat lot of space, will eat lot of memory, will eat lot of data transfer when you are using tags here. Whereas the JSON, so what is the basic format structure of the JSON data storage or the object storage?
Key value
pair. Very good. Attribute and the corresponding value. Key value pairs are going to be the most useful for us to represent that data representation and for exchange purpose in a more easy manner. That's why it is a very lightweight JSON when compared to our XML representation. So that's what we have seen in the last class. So let us see now, there is now please let us see this website. From this website you can use this web, you can also use it. This is just a free website for all of us, to people to practice it and get some information. You can also post something like this. So if you see here in the comments section, so what is this particular format? Can anybody tell me?
JSON.
Yeah, it is in JSON format, no doubt. But I'm expecting in which object form, in which JSON object form the representation is been seen to us.
A list.
List. More. You are on the track. I'm expecting
array.
Array. Very good. Array. Very good. Very good. Who said that array? So Mohammed. Salman. Yes. So here, please remember, it is an array. Please, can you see my screen here properly? Because it is an JSON array structure format. Last week, we have done that example of an array. So in the starting point, you have a square braces. Please see here, basically a square brace. Open square brace is there. Within the open square brace, what are these? Can anybody tell me? Let me just see how people are reacting to this. That is the only thing. Only thing, I just to make sure that you can also interact with me. That is the point of discussion here. Yes. just hold on. Yeah, please tell me now what is yes, this is a JSON structure, and basically the JSON, again it is an array. So if you see the starting square brace, open brace, so what is this from your open floor brace to a closing floor brace? So can anybody tell me what is that it is being called as?
Item.
Item object. Or your, yes, that is an object value. Once the entire thing is a object, but in that object we have different items here. We can call it as a message, or you can call it as an items. So please tell me what are in the item, what are the what is the information that we that is available with us at this moment? I'm talking about this within this open and closing floor brace. Post ID is one attribute, or you can have one key. ID itself is another attribute, or the key. Name is another key. Email is another one, and the body is another key. So for each key value, you have a corresponding value here. So for each item, that is, you can have this ID is one. This is the first value. The name is this. Email is email. Email IDs are there. Similarly, the second item, the ID is number two. The name, email, and the body values. ID number three, name, email, body, you have the corresponding values here. So this is how your JSON object. So how many elements are there? If you see, if you scroll down, you can see how many items are there in this entire JSON object.
500.
Very good. So 500 items are there in this. These are all basically. Can anybody tell me, or can anybody narrate what is this context value is from where they might have collected these values, or from what particular web applications, or from web resources you can have this kind of things? Anybody? Basically, some of these social networking websites, web applications, social networking web applications, and other email applications. So if you see here, these items are all related to, you have an item consisting of name, email, and a body. These are basically email conversations of different members, or different members of that particular social networking website, or it can be anything also. So just remember, these are certain dummy values only, of course, a fake values. This website is going to be useful for you just to take the data from these websites, from this web server. From this web server means from this web location, you can try to understand so many things here. So now let us bring these comments from this. Basically, these comments are in of what form? These comments are represented in the JSON format, right? Yes or no? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yeah, so this all these comments, now I want to retrieve it. I want to get it onto my web page. All these 500 emails, all these 500 items as a JSON format, I have to get it onto my web page. Can anybody tell me what how this can be done? Tell me the logic for this one. It is not very difficult. It is not a difficult task at all. You know the ideas now. You know all the important ingredients that are required to fetch this this JSON data onto your web page, onto your local machine. Yes, Raghavendra.
Sir, $document.geturl, like that, sir. Using jQuery, like $document.geturl, and we paste this URL there, so that it can fetch inside and we can retrieve its values.
Okay, very good. So any other views, please? Vinod, can you thank you. Vinod, can you tell me?
No different views, so same. We can fetch this
So yeah, Nisar, are you online, Nisar? Hello, Nisar Khan, are you online? Priyanka, are you online, Priyanka?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so can you tell me? Yes, Nisar or Priyanka, any one of you, please tell me how do you I fetch the JSON data from that website onto my local machine? Of course, we are discussing the topic on jQuery. We can make use of this jQuery to fetch the JSON data, the data which is present in the JSON format from a website onto my local machine. This is very, very important topic for everybody, please. If you understand this very simple thing, if you understand, then very, very good. You are in a good progress. I can confirm it. We have seen two examples now, as of now, in the previous cases. With those two examples knowledge, that is enough for us. Okay, I will ask, can anybody volunteer in typing the code? I will tell you what to be done so that you can, others also can please follow it. That will be more easy for us to have interaction. Hello, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yeah, Muhammad Sabir Hussain, are you online? Muhammad Sabir Hussain, are you online, please? No idea. Okay, Mr. Ali Akbar Faiz, are you online?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you please share your screen and type the code? I'll tell you how what to be done. I'll give you the guidance for you.
Sir, okay, but I'll have to join in from another browser because I was not ready. So,
okay.
If you can wait for like 5 minutes, I'll do it.
Okay. Anyway, you please keep working. I will ask you to do it, but keep working on that. You will be joining at some point. Okay.
No problem. Okay, sir. So you want me to consume a JSON file URL, and you will be seeing it.
Sorry, can you please repeat?
Sir, you want me to consume a JSON file?
Not consume. You have to fetch the JSON file. Yeah.
Yes,
you have to fetch that JSON file.
Okay, sir. Okay, on it.
Yeah. Please keep trying this one. In meantime, anybody can join the session immediately for starting the program. Sumit, are you online? Sumit Tomre. Yeah, Sumit, is it possible for you to share your screen for typing the code? Okay, you are using mobile. Okay, next time we will try with some when you are with your laptop, please let me know. Okay. Okay, what about Akash? Yeah, Akash. Is there anyone who is having the laptop can come forward? Because even if not today, maybe other sessions, I will be keep remembering your names so that I will keep always and be hunting you to show some outputs from your systems, please. So anyway, I'm not going to leave, if not today. At least once in the entire semester, at least once is required. Once or twice, at least, minimum once. Yeah, Funny, are you online, please?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Funny, can you please share your screen so that I will tell you the steps what to be done so that you can appreciate how do you write the jQuery statements for retrieving the JSON data onto your local system.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, please share your screen. Shall I stop my side? Yeah, you please share your screen. This is not a very big program at all. Please remember, just two or three lines of program. It is not a very big deal. Yeah, please open an editor. Very good. Open one new file. Yeah. Give a name to that one. Okay, week 6 index.html. Very good, fine. So just write the HTML head tags, then followed by body tags. Yes, just complete that. Very good. Perfect. In the body tags, very good. Okay, fine. Now in the head section, what needs to be done if you want to use jQuery statements? The first step is, yes, you need to include the library file. So that library file can be included with the help of your script source. So you please include script tags. Yes, script. Yes, open script and closing script. Yes, script. So how do you write that? Yes, script followed by, if you want to include the library, so script, the attribute is a source. So where you give the source? No, you'll give the attributes for the script tag outside. Yeah, so that is an attribute, source is equal to. So I will give that link for the library. Of course, if you get it from the Google, that is fine. But if you want, I'm copying and pasting it on the chat box. You just copy that paste and from the chat box here, the link for the jQuery library. I pasted it on the chat box. See here, please copy that. Are you able to see that? Yeah, copy paste it. Yes. 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 The closing, closing script tag. Yeah, closing script tag. Yes. Yeah, bring it to the top. No need to write anything, just it is a library, that's all. Yeah. Yeah, that's fine. You included the source. Yes, that's fine. Fine. So now that is you included. Now coming to the body section. Yes, now in the body section, what we need to be done? You are going to write the jQuery statements. So jQuery statements are to be written where? In which particular tags you have to write the jQuery statements? Yes, please. Again, your script tags has to be written because jQuery itself is a JavaScript. Please remember, all of you, please remember, jQuery itself is a JavaScript. Only thing is that JavaScript will be writing few number of lines of code, but it will do more work for us. Write less, do more. So script tags, please insert the script tags there in the body. Yeah, again, the script open tag and closing tag. Yes. Inside the script tag. Yes. Now what needs to be done? What needs to be done? Can anybody tell me? Yes, you need to write the jQuery statement. Dollar. Yes, always need to write the dollar here. So of course you are not playing anything. Dollar. You are not going to use any of those things here now at this moment. Document.onReady function. It is okay. That is fine. So you need to fetch the JSON data now. So dollar dot. Yes, please. Dollar dot. Yes, get JSON. Yes, JSON is in the capital letters. So JSON. Yes, open brace. You need to, yes, what is the structure it is asking you to give now? Please tell me. You got the help from the editor.
A URL.
URL. Yes, write down URL. URL. Just write down the name of the URL, comma. URL comma, you mentioned something like a function data. What are the data that you are going to fetch from that one? Function, F-U-N-C-T-I-O-N, function with an open brace, data, D-A-T-A. No, function within that, internally to the function, yes, data. Data, and for this function, you need to open flower brace. Open flower brace and closing flower brace. Open flower brace, just give some space there. Yes, so this jQuery statement at the end, you put semicolon. Yes. So what is this URL? We have not got the URL, right?
Yes, sir.
So yeah, create that variable there on the top before that jQuery statement inside the script only. How do you create a variable? Tell me.
No, sir.
Sorry?
No, I'm not saying anything.
Yeah, okay. So you first, where, var, where, variable, yes, space, URL is equal to, I think you need that URL, right? From the website, yes. I'm just pasting it on the chat window, please. All of you can copy that URL from the chat window so that it will be useful for your other exercises. So I have pasted the link. All of you, please copy this URL, jsonplaceholder.typecode.com. And along with the comments given there, yes. So comments is what you need to fetch it from that particular website. Yes, yes. Okay, now that's it. We have done it. So, okay, to make you to clearly understand, yes, you type something that function, inside that function, write on console.log, console.log, put open brace, closing brace, yes, right, within the quotes, right, inside the function. Yes, inside the function. Right, now save it. Save your program. Now run it. You are using this Visual Studio Editor. Yes, run the server. Hello, Fani. Are you online?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Where are you running?
1 minute.
Okay, you open the Google browser.
Open with server or just copy?
Anything is acceptable. Okay, to avoid the confusion, put some heading there. Go to the script file, yes. In the body section, give one heading. Example to in the body section, yes. Put some example for fetching data, fetching JSON data using jQuery. Okay, please save it. Again, refresh that page. Right, no, go to console. Can you refresh it again? Okay, now once you get the output, what is written in the output here?
Inside the function.
Inside the function, very good. You are inside the jQuery function now. So as of now, there are no red color marks. So as of now, okay, those are some warnings which are related to your browser settings, but that is not a big problem for you. Okay, now come to how do you, yes, can anybody tell me how do you display the data now that you have been fetched over there? Come to the script file, yes. Can anybody tell me how do you display the data? Data that is the data which has been held in the variable data.
So yeah. $.each function we have to use. Yeah.
No need, Baba. No need to go for internal things. Yeah, simply write. Yeah, funny. Please write on console.log in brackets data. That's all. Yes, display the data there first. Yeah. Yeah, go to the next line. Yes, yes. One more line you added. Yes, console.log. Yeah, console.log. Put the data. Now save the file and we refresh the file there. The data is a variable which you already collected that and you are going to, yes. Now you see there, yeah, what has been shown here? Can anybody tell me what has been shown on the console now? All the 500 items information has been shown. If you click here, any of that, yes, you can further explore. Yes, now you see that, yeah, exactly. So you see that body email of each item. If you want to see the first, this is 0 to 99, that is a 0th one, yes, the similarly. You can go to the first item, just click the one, you'll get the item number one, yes, that corresponding body, email, ID. So you are now able to fetch the JSON data which is available on that web server, that is on that website, onto your local browser. Are you getting this point, everybody?
Yes, sir.
How did we do this one? Again, this is again with the help of our jQuery only. Are you getting this point?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So any queries here for anybody? You are able to now fetch the data here. Now we can manage, we can manipulate these elements locally onto your system. Of course, you cannot change the data onto that website by looking from here. It will be hacking. That is called hacking. If you want to change that values from your local browser, that is going to be hacking. We are not doing any hacking here. We are just collecting the data and displaying it on our local browser and trying to understand how do you to fetch it and how do you process it. Later, we'll see how do we process and how do you do this one. So this is one example for the jQuery, say where you are going to get the JSON data itself. Similarly, if you have some websites, you can use your other websites to fetch your XML data or your JSON data. It is up to you. Using jQuery, you can practice all those things. I'll just pause for 10 minutes and I'll get back to you with the AJAX. So we'll be discussing AJAX also now after 10 minutes. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So we'll continue. Our topic is not over for today. Please remember all of you, those who are in the online session. So we'll start with the AJAX in another 10 minutes. So if you want more information, you can go to this website. What is the website name, please, for the jQuery? The official website. Hello. Am I audible to you, please?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you can go to jquery.com. So this is the official website from where you can download this library. Okay, now 3.6.0 is the latest library version. You can also download this 3.6.0, no problem. The older versions are also compatible. So even for jQuery, you have for mobile, for if you are doing mobile applications, it can be useful for your user interfaces. There are different related projects also here. So here, the material which I taken is from here only, DOM, traversal, and manipulation. So your dollar button, which is big, when it is hidden, like this, what you have seen them messages. So next we'll go for the AJAX. So how do we go for the AJAX? We'll see what to be done here. What is AJAX? How do we write program? What are all the AJAX functionalities? What is that strategy which will help you to fetch and receive the data? So for more information for the jQuery, you can go through this official website. That will be easy for you to quickly refer to. What are all the available methods? And if you look to the API documentation, all the available methods, you will get it, like your click function, show function, all this. So please remember, these are deprecated. Please remember, these are the old versions have been deprecated. So don't go for this. You can always go for the new version also. So if you just download this file, you can store it. So I am telling you how to download it. So here, you can go to the compressed version. Download the compressed development version or production version, it's up to you. Or you can go for the minified version also. So this is what your actual jQuery file, the program. You just please keep the same file name 3.6.0.min.js. Just save as. You can go with click save as and store jQuery.3.6.0.min.js at your appropriate folder or appropriate paths. And you, instead of, if you don't want to have the internet connection, if you are not available with internet connection, you can as well access this library and your files are going to be stored. I mean, files are going to be executed with the help of this library file. So this is another way you can always, this jQuery will be very much useful for your Internet of Things and other web applications and mobile applications too. So I'll just pause for 10 minutes. Now that is 3:30. So I'll be 3:40, we'll start the Ajax. Okay. So I'll just mute myself, mute the video, and I'll get back to you for the Ajax. Please don't leave away. Ajax is another important topic. Yeah. Yes, please. Any queries? Any queries? Yes, please. Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, so any queries, please? Any doubts? Shall we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now let us. Yes, please. Somebody is asking some doubt.
No. Sir, I'm saying we can go forward. Like
yeah. Good. So let us move ahead. So now the topic is very important one. We call it as AJAX, AJAX, which is basically the abbreviation is asynchronous JavaScript and XML. Of course, the name is somewhat older. This is somewhat old technology. Which people have, but this has got a lot of functionalities and a lot of advantages are there with this technology, more especially getting the dynamic data that is to be displayed onto our web pages or for our web resources. So if you want, let us move forward and see to understand this in a better way. Let us take some small example here. So we have two computers. One computer is basically is one system which is located at a different place. The other is basically a computer, which is basically a web server, is also located on the other end of your network. Or it is assume that both these computers are across the networks, across the internet, which they are located at different places. So you are sitting on this particular left hand side computer and you are trying to get some information from a particular web server or from a server from a particular location. So whenever you are trying to access that information is something like index.php, a web page. Basically, this PHP files are being stored on the web server, where a web server means all the information related to the website are being made available at this particular system, on this particular system on the right hand side. So usually
you are not presenting.
Oh, sorry. Then you said okay. Sorry. Yeah. Sorry. So anyway, I'll repeat it again. It is not a very big thing. Okay. So is my screen visible to you now?
Yes, sir.
So actually, I was referring to this diagram on this. So let me just come back from the beginning. So we have topic on important technology called asynchronous JavaScript and XML, a technology which is helpful for you to retrieve the data as and when it is available on the web server. So that is what this technology is basically. To understand it in a better way, so we'll see with a small example here. Try to understand this small example where you have two computers, one computer on the left hand side and the other computer on the right hand side of this figure. But basically these two computers are across the internet, across the network. It means they are located at different places. They are not at the same place. They are not at the same location, in other terms. So you are sitting on one particular computer, assume that you are sitting on the left hand side. Basically this computer, we call it as a client. And this client, using your browser, what you do, that client is trying to request some information, get some information. That client, as a user, you are sitting on that client computer and you are trying to get some information which is available on a web server. So the web server is particular one particular computer where all the information related to your website are present at that particular machine. So your website will have so many web pages, so many web links, so many other web resources. So all that particular resources of that website are available at one particular machine, that is your web server. So when you are trying to access that information, or when you are trying to browse that information which is located on another computer or another web server, so usually you send the command get. So something like get index.php. So it means you are sitting on the client computer and you are trying to get some information of a particular website or a particular web page, that web page which is located on the other computer, that is on your web server. So your arrow mark here, there is an arrow mark. So you are requesting the information and that information is going to your web server. And that request is coming from as a get index.php. Now what web server, that server is a person who is going to serve your request. So you have made a request. That request is getting that index.php. That is a request you have given from a computer, that's from the client side. And that request has come to the server about to provide the service for that index.php. So what server is going to do is, server is going to give some information here. So what is that server is going to give? The HTTP followed by the version 1.1 version of that HTTP with the status code 200 along with the content. So what is this index.php content is there? That content in the form of your web page, your HTML and the body section, that entire information that is present with respect to that index.php, that web content, that is being served to that requested person. So once this information is given, the client information, it is completed. So you are getting the request. Once the request has come, the server has served the request. It means the server has given that information to the client. So once this particular transaction, in the sense that this particular activity, requesting and serving, this particular activity is over, it is over, that's all. But later, what happened is, please understand the scenario now. Suppose there is a new information is coming in this particular index.php or some other web page. New index information is coming here on the web server. Something like the latest game or the cricket scores, cricket score or your football score or your live stock information or something, the latest live data, the data which keeps on updating on the web server. So that kind of applications where the data is getting updated very frequently, very fastly and very very much most of the time the data gets updated here, that data which is getting updated on the web server. So if you are trying to access that kind of information using the same above scenario, the above diagram, getting the request and serving the request, but the web server is trying to give you only once the information, and again that request again needs to be done like this, it is a continuous process. So the user means as a web developer or a web customer or a web user, he cannot always request for the latest information by saying get the latest information, get the latest information, and the server keeps on giving for the servicing for all the requests. So getting, get the request, serve the request, get the request, serve the request, if these are the things, it is a very time consuming process. So what happens is this technology, the Ajax technology, will enable, will help the web developer as well as from the user. So this program, like getting the value and getting the latest value and that latest request is going to be served automatically without refreshing the web page, without sending the GET request. That needs to be done without refreshing. Means once you refresh the web page, again your request is going to come. So refreshing the web page means whenever you something like if you see, if you go to something like a web page, and suppose if you are going for our university web page, most of the time, some of the web pages, these contents are going to be static. If the contents are very much dynamic, then what you need to do, you keep on pressing the refresh button. So once you press the refresh button, you get the latest information, like your cricket scores or your football scores or your live stock informations or your banking informations. So whenever you want the latest information, you keep on refreshing it. So whenever you refresh it, so what is exactly happening in the refresh process? So if you see your go to tools, developer tools, so you can go to the network. So if you see here, keep on, if you are refreshing it, so you're again refreshing means again your request has been sent, your requests are going to be served. So like this, each request are going to be coming with different set of values. So all the time this is gets more a complex task, trying to get the information for every latest information. So that getting the latest information for every content that is getting updated, that news need not to be done again and again. So need not be refreshed again and again. So like this, once you refresh it, you are getting the information from the web server. Again, when you refresh it, again it is going to, your request is again been sent, again you are getting the latest information. So refreshing is nothing but getting the latest information, refresh button. That's why refresh, we reload or refresh, we do this again and again to get the latest information. But without refreshing it, without reloading it, without sending that GET option, how we can try to fetch the latest data that is available on the web server. So that is what our point of discussion here now. That topic we are going to discuss something called Ajax. So Ajax provides, that is asynchronous JavaScript and XML. That's what you see here, asynchronous JavaScript and XML. That is the abbreviation for this. So Ajax provides an ability to communicate with the server asynchronously. Please remember, so you are from the client. Whenever you send the request, that is the GET information, that information, you are going to get the responses. So that getting the information or getting the responses for the requested information, all these things are happening asynchronously. It is not synchronous, it is asynchronous. Request has been sent, then you get the corresponding response. That is asynchronous, one after the other. Request, then followed by response. So that is what you got asynchronously. So Ajax is a client-side technique. That is a technique, that is a strategy. So that combines a set of known technologies in order to create faster and more user-friendly web pages. And Ajax is based on JavaScript, and the main functionality is to access the web server inside the JavaScript code. Ajax is not a programming language. Please remember, it is a methodology, it is a strategy on using several other web technologies to fetch the data asynchronously and to exchange the information very fastly and asynchronously. So that's what you can see from the left-hand side of the diagram. Whenever you send a GET request, the web server is going to service it. This all things are happening automatically if you use this Ajax technology, Ajax strategy, Ajax methodology. So how do we make use of this Ajax methodology? The Ajax strategy is the point of discussion now. So on the right side of this diagram, you can see the actual programming statements. So in order to use this Ajax technology, the first statement that you need to use it is basically you need to create an Ajax object or an XML object. So here, if you see the first instruction here, so there is an XML object here. So that is a request object, XML, HTTP. You can give any other name, but basically this is nothing but that object is of what type? That object is of XML HTTP request. That is an object. So you know what is the variable name followed by new followed by the XML HTTP request. This is a function, key function. So it's XML HTTP request object is getting created. That is, we can give a name, something like ABC also, it is fine. But please understand that is of, that should be of type XML HTTP request. So using that object, we use certain methods here. So this one method is, first that object is trying to open a connection, that a connection which is to be established with the server where that particular file is located. So if you're looking for a file called gamelist.php, that file information is to be get. That's why if you are using here get, it can be post. We'll see what is post and get in the later, in the when you look into the server side scriptings, we'll see what is get and post more closely. But at this moment, please understand, get is basically this particular method. By default, you are going to get the information what is related to the gamelist.php, one web page, one server file page, which is located on the server. So it can be true or it can be false. Basically, the true is implies that it can be asynchronous way. If it is asynchronous, you can put it either way. It can make it as a true or a false if you don't want asynchronous. So now that particular, once the connection is established, you are sending that particular information and you are going to retrieve that information onto your DOM object and to display it. So that's what you can see, this basic method of your AJAX. One is your XML HTTP request, another is your open, and another is your send. So let us see this with writing the program and see, understand how this goes on. So why we need AJAX is, because HTML pages or your web pages are basically the dynamic contents are to be displayed. So as and when some data is getting updated on the web server, and if you, that data, updated data has to be seen on the client side automatically without an explicit request from the user, this AJAX technology is going to be much useful for us. So interaction with user, it becomes slower as functionality increases. Of course, a little bit limitations. Again, you can say it as a drawbacks or some kind of limitations when there are more set of functionalities are going to be there. When the HTML pages, the JavaScripts, the speed is most important for us. So AJAX is going to be very much useful for us. So here, most of the time, you might have seen that the simple example like this. So when you type google.com, something like this, when you say Chrome, see here, almost to Chrome on Raspberry Pi, something like this, automatic suggestions are coming to you. All these are nothing but your AJAX technology only, to be very much frankful, we say. So Google has used this AJAX technology, of course, a decade back. So of course, they are now improved with this XML HTTP request. We'll see it in a later stage. But in the early days of Google, when you are getting suggestions like this from the Google server itself, you will get the suggestions. This is basically because the background of this technology is AJAX technology only. So whatever you type, you'll get some suggestions here, automatic suggestions. Basically, those are the suggestions you get it here. So that suggestions are basically coming with the help of your AJAX technology only. So once you establish your own web server, then you can fetch your data from those web server databases too, and you can get some suggestions too. So as of now, this is one simple example where AJAX is very much useful for us. So let us move forward with some examples on how do you write this AJAX. So another important point when you're playing with the AJAX is again coming back to the DOM structure. Please remember the DOM structure. DOM provides a standard set of objects for representing your HTML and as well as XML documents. Please remember this. So to access this DOM elements with along with the XML HTTP request object, you have to be very careful when you're using this as an JSON object or as a simple object variable. So what I mean to say is you have a DOM set of elements. So whenever you are playing or whenever you have to manipulate the data with respect to those elements, you need to prepare that particular data elements in a particular form. So basically that is, you can do it with the help of your JSON object representation. And where this, once the documents are going, document elements are going to be accessed, so you can give the corresponding response text that is coming from the server to apply on these particular elements very easily. That's what the DOM structure is again very useful for us. So whenever you're using this XML HTTP request, please remember it means you are using AJAX technology. So AJAX technology requires some methods for you to understand here. So the first method is the open method. You need to use the XML HTTP request object to use this function called open. And the open function requires three parameters basically. The first one is the method. The method can be either get or a post. If it is a secured way of data transfer, you can use post. Otherwise, you can get you can use simply the get itself, followed by the URL. URL means from where the location or the file which you are looking for from a particular web server. It is basically the web content which you are trying to access, which you are trying to retrieve, or which you are trying to get your information. So method is basically get, followed by the URL, the location where your information is to be retrieved, followed by if it is asynchronous or if it is synchronous, or it can be true or false, the Boolean value. So it's basically synchronous or asynchronous. If true, this is basically implies that asynchronous, by default, it will be true only, asynchronous way. So this is asynchronous JavaScript and XML. That's what your AJAX technology is. But whenever you establish the connection and you try to retrieve the data, there are certain important things that you need to make a note. So sometimes that requested information may not be available on the web server. Sometimes the data that you're looking, that is the data that is you're looking, may not be available. Whether it can be a success or it can be not unsuccessful if the web page is not available on the web server. So most of the times you might have seen some web page getting a response such as 404. It means the web page is not available on the web server. Usually the success code will be of 200. That's what the status code is. So we'll see there are different codes are there, 50, 500, you'll have 300, 400, different series of codes are there. So when we study about the web servers more clearly, that response codes, the status codes will be, we'll see more clearly. But at this moment, please understand, the status code 200 implies it is a successful. It means the web page you are looking is available at so-and-so web server or at so-and-so place. It implies that the information is going to be given to you and that web response, that request response is going to give the status. If you are getting the status code of 404 means the requested web page or a web resource is not available at that particular location or on that particular web server. So just we'll see some programs, how do we write and how do we get a best benefit of this AJAX technology. So the benefits of using AJAX is that it helps you to build fast and dynamic. That's what the dynamism on the behavior of the web elements, the data values of those web elements will be seen, will be updated, which will be seen immediately by the user whenever the data gets updated on the web server. AJAX allows to perform processing on client computer. So basically AJAX is a client-side technology. Please remember it is not a server-side. For the client, it is helping the client to easily fetch the data as and when the data is get updated on the web server. So using the JavaScript only, we can do this of fetching the data or retrieving the data using AJAX technology. So the data taken from the server, thereby reducing the server load. So you can always avoid the means the transmission, the get request and the response request, getting always. You can minimize those things with the help of this AJAX technology. So thereby you are going to save the bandwidth. That is by only transmitting the new information whenever the new information is available on the server. So no need to reload the page. So that's what I was telling to you. No need to refresh the page. So it can automatically be retrieved from the web server. If you're refreshing means you're trying to refresh means you're reloading the page. It implies that you're trying to get the latest information. But when you use AJAX technology, the AJAX automatically will send the transmit the new information. You need not reload the page. So the disadvantages of AJAX is that it is a poor compatibility with very old or obscure browsers. The old browsers do not support these AJAX capabilities, but nowadays all the latest browsers do support. And of course, some of the mobile devices will have lightweight mobile browsers. So that again, it will be a little bit difficulty in executing this AJAX technology. So again, there are other alternative technologies for this one. I'll get back to that in the later stage. Let us not confuse it here at this moment. Limited capabilities like multimedia, interaction with webcams and printers, local data storage, and real-time graphics. So we have some kind of displays. Yeah, any doubts, please? Fish? Can you please mute yourself, Shailesh? Yeah, so here too much code makes the browser slow. That is one of the limitations when you try to write most functionalities. So obviously the responses that you are going to get it from the server makes the browser to display your data very slowly. And JavaScript, of course, the JavaScript is to be enabled on the browser to have the automatic retrieving of data through your Ajax. So let us see some demo here on writing how to use this Ajax and how do we go about it. So let us, so we'll take an editor here. Of course, I'm taking my editor here. We'll get back to this fetching the data. So of course, to fetch the data again, I'll be using the same website here, jsonplaceholder.typecode.com. So we'll use the same thing for the same example comments so that you can understand the differences or how do you understand the importance of Ajax and try to understand how best you can write it along with the your JSON's things. So here, so before we go, that material is already available on this one. And let me open a new file. So let me just take. The jQuery's along with this JSON's some other program. Okay, so fetching JSON data from the URL using the jQuery example is what you have done inside this program in the previous one. So let us now go with this the same example that you are trying to fetch it, but with the help of your Ajax. So let us go with the Ajax itself to get the JSON data onto this particular file. So here you can go to the script. jQuery can be kept like that only. So fetching JSON data from a URL using I'll try to say something on this. Using Ajax here. So let us keep the same thing on this function. Okay, the script function. Let me see this. Okay, hold on. I already have the program with me, I think here. Yeah, so here, let me just the same the file. Okay, fine. So in the script file, of course, jQuery will come back to that in the later stage. The first statement is, I am just creating a XML HTTP request object. So this XML HTTP request object is one XHR, you can give your name anything, that's what I said, ABC, that doesn't make any problem for us. So this, and you are using, one second. So this entire thing, let me just. Yeah. And this, once you create the XML HTTP request object, so the first command is, you are going to use the open command. Right, so once the open command, syntax for this open command is, there are three parameters. The first parameter is, of course, I have just given in the slide for you. So if you see the slide, you can see the XML. open syntax. Yeah, this is your open method, the method, URL, and the Boolean value. So here, the same thing, the method is, you can use get or a post. I'm using the get here. And the URL, URL is the same thing, jsonplaceholder.typecode.com/comments. And of course, the third parameter is by default, it is true. So I'm giving, you can keep it true. True implies what, please? Hello?
Asynchronous.
Yeah, it is asynchronous. Please refer to the slide I have given to you. If true, it is implies the asynchronous. Why? What is meant by asynchronous here? Can you please just little bit say something on this? What do you mean by asynchronous? Yes, please.
Like, we need not refresh the web page all the time. It, the data will be reflected or as the time passes. As you give an example of cricket scores, live cricket scores.
Yeah, cricket scores, that is fine. But please remember, I'm just expecting one good answer here. Of course, your answer is correct. Can you please tell me what is that asynchronous here by looking to this diagram at least? Hello? Am I audible to you, please?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yes.
Yeah, is my screen visible to you? The yes, PPT is, yeah. So can you see what do you understand from this screen? Please tell me on the left side of this figure. This is very, very important. If you understand this, Ajax is over then. The left side screen, there are two diagrams. On the left side of my screen, there are two diagrams are there. On the top diagram, there is something, and on the bottom diagram, there is something. Can anybody tell me what is this you understood? What I have explained to you a little bit earlier here. Whatever I explained, can you please spell it out, what that you understood here? You are not understood?
The return from the server is HTML in the first one. And here it is data, simple data, XML.
Okay, you are just trying to say what is written there actually. But can you please tell me what is this process? What is this activity? See, the there is a client, the left side computer is a client, and the right side computer is a server. One second, I'm explaining to all of you, please listen here carefully, just very simple thing. So from the client, there is a request coming. Request has been given. You can see the arrow mark. The arrow mark tells that the request is coming from the client to the web server. What request is that? What is that request? Get index.http. I want this index.http, please. I miss here, the client is asking. Once the request has come here to the web server, if that index.php page or the web page is available on this web server, then what this web server is going to do? This web server is going to serve that request. So the request has been sent to this particular client here. Request has been sent from the server to the clients. What information? Basically, it is going to, whatever the information that this request has been made, that content, the HTML content is been sent to this particular client. So request and response, request and response, request and response, that is the asynchronous way. Asynchronous means request, after request is come, then the response is going to be given back. Both request and response, both are not having at the same time. It is one after the other. Please remember, that is the actual asynchronous way. Asynchronous. What is the meaning of asynchronous? See, I am asking you the question now. After I ask the question, you are responding to me. You are responding to me means you are giving some answer to me after I ask the question. This is asynchronous. Are you getting this point, please? What is meant by asynchronous? Hello? Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what is synchronous?
Continuous exchange of data.
Continuous exchange of data. Again, you are not exactly giving that meaning of what I'm expecting, that actually synchronous means. In this context, what is the meaning of asynchronous and synchronous? That you please try to tell me.
So request and response on the same time.
Sorry, Sachin, can you please repeat?
Request and response on the same time.
Yeah, request and response. If both are at the same time, is it possible like that? Most of the time, is it possible like that?
No, sir. Once we query and then we get the
response. Yeah, for some applications it's possible, but not for all the applications. It is possible. Okay, so here request and response. Once I make a request and once I get the response, it is basically an asynchronous way. See, if you are giving the answer while the time I'm asking the question itself, it is going to be very much synchronous. If you are able to understand what question I am going to ask, and if you are also going to give before my completion of the question, if you are giving the answer and both the question and answer are at the same time, then it is basically we can term it as synchronous. So most of the time you are going to, what the web servers are going to do is, it will be in the asynchronous way of communication only. Please do remember that particular point. So that's what your asynchronous way, that is, okay, now let me just go to the program here. So the program is basically, yes, you are going to get that information from this placeholder. And once that, once the open connection has been established, you are going to send that request. So xhr.sendRequest has been made here from this particular client side, that is from your browser side. So let us see how this program is going to run and see what is that you are going to get it from this side. So here, before we move on to this, okay, this is the basic steps of AJAX technology. So you are going to get that information from this website. So that information is being brought by the XML HTTP request object. The object is there here. In the program only, this object is automatically doing some work for you instead of refreshing and reloading here. So here, So once the object has made some connection, once the open connection has been done and the request has been sent, so what needs to be done once you get the response, the request response? Once you get the response here, so xhr.onload. Onload means your web page. Once you get the response, that function is going to execute it. That response is going to come. So let us see what is that response here. So I'm just printing that response, console.log. You can see that this refers to this XHR. XHR means this current XML HTTP request object. That object's response text. What is that response text? We'll see. We'll see what is the response you get it once you make some request. So the request, what is the request I made? Anybody can tell me what is the request I made here in my request from the web page? What is that I'm trying to get?
JSON data.
JSON.
Yes. JSON data from which one? Which one?
The comments.
Only the comments, please. If you see this web page, please see the web page again. Again, I'm showing that web page. Where is that web page? Yeah, once that placeholder. Yeah, 1 second. Placeholder. I put it here. So also, let me open that placeholder. See this placeholder. This is the comments. So that's comments is that comments are available in the JSON format. So this is the JSON placeholder website. If you see, there are so many things again, not only just simply comments, you have simply other things like post, other things like, yes, these are the posts. So again, posts are also in the JSON format. And if you see the albums, there are 100 albums are there. What are the different titles, user ID and the ID number. Similarly, the photos. So these are the different photos, which they are the placeholders where the photos are available here. You can also put some values, to do's, like this. There are different things are there. So I'm just referring to one comments here. You need not worry about only comments. You can fetch the albums, photos, to do's, users, and everything also from this place. So now let us see. This is what I'm trying to fetch the data. So once I run this, so these are the important steps. Please remember it. What are the important steps? Once again, I repeat the steps for your AJAX. Very simple AJAX. Three important steps. First, you have to create an XML HTTP request object. This object is of type XML HTTP request. That's what this is, the syntax. This is a keyword XML HTTP request. Once you create that object, you need to say that object has to be connected so that it can get some information. So you need to write get followed by what information. You have to specify the URL, and by default it will be asynchronous way. So you are getting, it means you are sending the request. So once you prepare that statement open, then you issue the command xhr.send. Once you send this one, okay, you can write this statement here also, but I'm just writing below this object so that you can understand what that response will be there. So once you send that request, you get the response here. That response is once you get, that means the page is going to be loaded, xhr.onload function. You get some response here. So what is that response? We will see what is that it is responding, whether that, yes, it is. We know that definitely that page is available. So I will show you if that page is not available, what is that you are going to get? We'll see. So let us see first what is that you are going to get if that really that page is available on that server. So open the program and just run that program. So this is what the heading statement. So go to the developer tools, go to the console. Yes. So now if you see here carefully, let me refresh this again. So the comments, all that comments, whatever you are seeing there, all that comments have been displaying it on the console here within this array itself. So you can see these are all the values that you can see it here. That's what you can see it on the console.xml HTTP request. That is the response, that is the request response you are getting here. So now let us see. This dot response text, this is what the, that is a response text, that is the JSON file request, that is JSON file is been responded here. So let us see here, before the response text itself, instead of looking for the exact text, let me just show you before that one, what is this exactly that file is going to look like, the output of that particular file. See, this is what, just simply an XML HTTP request object. If you expand this one, you'll see there's so many things are there here. So what is that response text? You see, once again, I'm repeating it. If you just simply place this without using the response text, you will see that this is nothing but it is referring to XHR XML HTTP request object. That XML HTTP request object is being seen here on the console. That's what XML HTTP request. You can say that ready state is 4, at least you can see that one. And if you expand this one, you'll see a lot of information here. So those who are in the beginners, you need not worry about all this set of attributes here, but at least some minimum things are required here. Something minimum things means, see here the status. What is the status? The request page, the status code will tell you that 200 means that web page is available. It is successful in getting that information from the web page. And you are send this, this is what your response URL, and this is what your response text. So at present, the response text, if you put your mouse pointer here, you can see all the set of values here, but it is not clear for you. That's why you can just copy this response text and you can extract that response text here by placing this dot response, So just type the response text attribute here. This dot, you can say simply response text. Save it here. Then once again, you refresh it now. So instead of, yeah, now you can, I'm just putting the same thing. So now you see here, instead of all those along with the attributes, the success states, numbers, and all, you those, that information is not there. Only the requested, the response of that response text is nothing but the actual data. The response text is the data, that is what your JSON data is there, that you are able to get it onto your, see, still some much of the code is there as of now in this browser, you are supporting this much only. So this you are going to get it onto your particular, see, these are all the actual values that you can see it on the mouse pointer which you are displaying it there. So now, if suppose I am just giving some other something like, instead of requesting something like ABC. Let us assume that just as simply an ABC, whether your ABC is there or not. I'm just now refreshing that page again. I refresh the page again. Can you please tell me what has been shown on the screen here?
404.
Yes, 404. So what is this 404 indicates? Can anybody tell me?
A smartphone.
Sorry, 404?
It is not found, sir.
It is not found. Yeah, it is not found. It is basically the request information. That is what the request information that you are getting a response on your console that stating that 404 is the status code. 404 implies that it is not available. Yes, that we not that is not available here. That's what we know. For you to understand, I have just given here. If you say something which is already there, you can say, you can practice these things. So you put it in the comments. You know that very well, that particular web page is available. You can fetch. Similarly, you can photos, albums. So like that, you, the exact data, you are going to get it here. So now this is one thing here. So what you are getting this data is basically, this is the data that you are getting is in the form of a string. Please remember it, all of you. So what you are getting is basically a string form here. Please do remember that very, very important point. This is basically the response text that you are getting is basically a string form. So let us now, instead of giving this the string form, you can say something like this. If you want to make a JSON object, instead of a string, I want to print, I want to create it as the native JSON object itself, instead of a string. Can anybody tell me what needs to be done here? Hello?
Sir, once again, repeat, sir.
See, what you are, once you have fetched the data, once you have received it, the received data is basically what you are seeing. It is on the console. I'm just showing here. This is a text data or a string data, a string format. It is not a particular kind of representation. Though it looks like you are closing square brace and open floor brace and everything is there, it is not a native JavaScript object. This, what are the data you are seeing? It is just a string only, or it is set of characters that you can see it here. It is just a set of characters with what are the characters that are available on that particular file. If you want to create a native JSON object, what needs to be done here? Anybody?
Parsing.
Very good, very good. So already I think this guy has already done a parsing. So anyway, I have not covered this, your string to the parsing. So just with curiosity, I asked it. So anyway, we'll do that parsing in the next week class. As of now, we are not going to handle anything at this moment. Parsing. So JSON parse method, I have not discussed with you, JSON.parse method. That we will see, miss stringify, we call it as stringify and parsing methods. That we will discuss it in the next week for the JSON along with the AJAX examples. So if you see the exercises now for this week, so okay, I'll just pause and we'll continue this in the next week. Still jQuery and AJAX are there still, it is not yet completed. So I just given you a brief introduction of this one. So for today's discussion, you can go with the exercises what I have prescribed for you. So if you see this exercises here, which is given, just 1 second, please. Yeah. So now you can please create a basic plugin for the operations using the jQuery user interface and the forms. So that is the first exercise. You can create your own plugin for various jQuery operations for various user interfaces. You assume whatever the data you like to have. And for the exercise two, you can use different attributes in the classes and the CSS manipulations. Write jQuery to perform the following actions. So here, the instructions are add the outlined cascading stylesheet class to each of these three boxes. So each of the three boxes, three boxes. And you need to toggle the colors whenever the appropriate boxes are going to be pressed by the on the web page. And something like you can give a survey. So you design and develop the following interface. Of course, this user interface survey, you can take any of the websites. If at all you enter the name, that corresponding details has to be fetched upon. You can use the jQuery and the JSON. And of course, you can use the other set of operations. And the fourth exercise, you develop AJAX so that it uses any of the JSON file or XML file. Of course, the example what I have shown you is on the JSON file. This is a JSON file which has been fetched from that particular website. That's what from this particular website, the JSON file is there. You can also go for any XMLs also. And one second, let me open the, yeah. So use any of those JSON or XML file as input and display the read data without changing the front end of your application. So please assume appropriate members and data and for the design and development of the required applications. So you can, for all these exercises, you assume appropriate things. I have just given you the screen prints for you to get an idea, that's all. Of course, even I have taken it from other web sources only, but nevertheless, you can assume your own set of ingredients and you can try to fill up that particular instructions. Accordingly, you can manipulate it. Accordingly, you can provide that application. Need not be exactly what is being asked here. So you can provide the functionalities according to your application requirements. This is only just a indicative kind of interface design that is given to you. So please do these exercises, just four exercises. Of course, I have given around 11 to 12 days. So yeah, any queries here, please? Hello, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
I'll just stop for today's discussion at this moment. We will see the Stringify and other things on the next week's class, along with the cookies, one exercise on the cookies. Any other, any queries, any doubts at this moment? Regarding the evaluations, already mentioned, Srinivas Raju will be the, yeah, if you have any evaluation, already some of them have got evaluated. If you have any queries, please, you can put forward now or you can directly contact Srinivas Raju. I will be online only. If you have any queries, please put forward. No problem. Don't hesitate to ask me. Yes, please. I'll just, yeah, sir, for lab 5 assignment, do we have to submit it in the zip format or just the PDF is enough? If you can submit in the zip format, that is well acceptable because your source code is also going to be available. That is most preferable one. PDF is only for the first one or two exercises only. I mentioned about the screenshots and the corresponding thing. So please do put your source codes. That is more important. Anyway, I'll put as an announcement section, I'll keep them at least from the lab 5 onwards, you will try to, lab 4 onwards only, you have to submit your source codes also. Am I clear to you, Salman? Yeah, you can zip both HTML files along with the PDF. That will be more apt one because it will be easy for us to refer to the outputs also. Both source codes and PDF, both are required, please. That will be more flexible one for us. Yeah, Vinod, please tell me.
Sir, many of us till now, we submitted a PDF file only.
Yeah, please don't worry, no problem. From now onwards, yeah, from now this week onwards, you please submit the codes also. Codes along with the PDF.
No problem, sir. We'll submit a zip file.
Yeah, you submit as a zip file. That will be enough for us.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, any other queries, please?
Sir,
yes, please.
Code screenshot is not needed if we including.
See, for, up to now, you if you have kept only the screenshots, that is fine. But from now, this week onwards, from this exercise onwards, please put your source codes as well as PDF as a zip file and submit it.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes, we know. Am I clear to you? Yes, please. Am I clear to you?
Actually, sir, I'm saying if we including source code file in the zip format, then we do not need to take a screenshot of the code.
No, no, no. Screenshot of the code, please take it as well as the output also. Please, both, all you put it as a zip file. All of the things will be there.
Okay.
Only from this week onwards, whatever you have done in the earlier stage with the screen print of your source code and your outputs, along with that one, please provide the source code also from this week onwards. In the zip file. Yeah. So next to next week, you will be starting the JSP, Java Server Pages. So once the server side has also been started, then you can understand easily the client and the server communication and the exchange of data. So whatever the small exercises that you are done with this can also be done by fetching your own data from your own web server instead of the other fake websites and other sources. Last time, I think one of them, exactly, I do not remember the name actually. One guy was requesting for clarification on that evaluation. I'm not sure. Can you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It was me.
Yeah, Ali Akbar. Yeah, please. Ali Akbar, you can contact Srinivasa. Are you online, Srinivasa?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Please look into this Ali Akbar's request and you need some clarification there.
Yes,
maybe
sir, sure.
You can contact them and after the session is over or in yes, the later sir. Stage, whenever. So, Ali Akbar, yes, please follow up with Srinivasa, okay? Instead of wasting time for others, so that's why I just ask you to contact me.
Okay, sir.